And speaking of the last person who will enter Jannah, the last person. And amazingly, it says the person will be given not just equivalent to the entire dunya and what it had, but that 10 times. 10 times! Imagine, today, take a look at what the dunya has. And to be honest with you, this is only a description to bring it close to the mind, because nothing that we've got in this world qualifies to come to the akhirah. Not the beautiful perfumes, not the technology, completely. No WhatsApp in paradise, remember this. No, not at all. Anything you've thought of, any phones and iPhones and whatever, no ways. So if someone says, I'm not going to have my games in heaven, what am I going to do there? I'll be bored. You haven't even thought for a minute. You know, we are being occupied with so many things here. It's not going to come. Imagine everything of value in this world, if it was yours and yours alone, and you were the boss and the king of whatever was there, every single thing, whether it, no matter what it is, imagine it was yours. And the hadith says, multiply that by 10 and convert it to that which is in heaven. So it's not the cheap stuff of this world. You put a battery in your phone, the battery goes. You use the phone for a while, it stops functioning. Something happens, you know, you start wilting. Jannah is not like that. You don't wilt. You are at a beautiful age. It's reported that the age of 33, a certain height, beauty. You look how you want to look, subhanallah. How do you want to look? MashaAllah, you look like that. Now what do you want? That's the afterlife. What's the point of talking about all this when we haven't even prepared for it? May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive us, really. And this is why it's important for us to know that reading about heaven and hell should mainly make us focus upon achieving heaven and staying away from hell. Why does Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala describe the people of hellfire? And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, and this is the life after. وَنَادَى أَصْحَابُ النَّارِ أَصْحَابَ الْجَنَّةِ أَنْ أَفِيضُوا عَلَيْنَا مِنَ الْمَاءِ أَوْ مِمَّا رَزَقَكُمُ اللَّهِ قَالُوا إِنَّ اللَّهَ حَرَّمَهُمَا عَلَى الْكَافِرِينَ الَّذِينَ اتَّخَذُوا دِينَهُمْ لَهُوًا وَلَعِبًا وغرتهم الحياة الدنيا فاليوم ننساهم كما نسوا لقاء يومهم هذا وما كانوا بآياتنا يجحدون. On that day, the people of hellfire will call out to the people of heaven, asking them to pour on them some water or liquid, anything that Allah has bestowed you with, pour it on us. We are struggling, we are suffering, we are being burnt, we are struggling in such a way that this heat is immense and intense. Pour on us something that Allah has given you. And the people of Jannah will say, that's one thing we're not allowed to do. Allah has prohibited that against those who disbelieve. They belied. You knew what was right, you turned away. And Allah says, on this day, nansahum, we will forget them in the same way that they forgot us. Where did they forget us? When they were in the world, we sent them messages. We sent them messengers. We sent them reminders. We made sure that we created them in a way that they knew that they're going to leave the world, but they didn't prepare for the day they left. Subhanallah. فلكم طال الجهد وكم قاسى قلبي وتعلم حتى فاح الروض ولاح المجد على أوطاني أعواما مرت عشناها أياما لسنا ننساها واليوم نلبي لنداها بشهادات وتفاني بشهادات وتفاني نرفع رايات البشرى ونرجل